Welcome, one and all, to Sackinima's Best in Show. This is Matt, or Mateos, here to present the last level recording from episode 28. This is Supercharged Tower Defense by chronos453, which was awarded for engaging strategic construction. I'll be showing a recording of the level followed by a bit of commentary on what makes it great. To play it yourself ahead or at any time, simply follow the lbp.me link in the video description. And if you would like an opportunity for your own levels to be featured in a future Best in Show, make a thread for them on Sackinima Forums, or tweet a link to @SackinimaForums on Twitter. Now begins this playthrough of Supercharged Tower Defense, brought to you by Hours of Dedication.
Thank you.
I like a good tower defense game, and this one certainly makes the cut. You've got a decent selection of towers, of course, ranging from the dinky one that is almost a waste of points to buy an upgrade, to the uber tower that fires a satisfying laser cannon, but still ignores enemies that are almost at the end in favor of ones that just emerged from the portal. It doesn't happen in this recording, so they don't know, but I know. I know. In addition to the towers, there is also a set of support units, such as beacons that can be manually triggered to perform super attacks or buffs. Their presence can make or break a playthrough. Then there are mines. Yeah, you won't find much use for the mines. They're pricey and don't stay on the map, and oh my god, it can regenerate! Plant the mines! Plant them, plant them, plant them! The level expertly presents scenarios and enemy variations where you really have to consider the strengths and weaknesses of each tower. Ice is all well and good, but it won't work on special units. And rune towers are the best, so have two of them because you can. This is an easy one to get into and start playing, maybe even making it quite a few levels in. But to really master and beat it requires that extra degree of thought and strategy, so it's kind of the best of both worlds. Oh, and did I mention that there are multiple maps and a bunch of extras to unlock for those who want them? Because this has all of that too. And how could I forget the comments that come up? Of course I read these. They're great! Sometimes they give useful information, like tips on how to play better or information about an upcoming wave. Why would you wait to tell me this until after I've had two rounds of them? Other times, it's just a friendly little companion to have in what would otherwise be a cold, unending series of shots, explosions, and lasers. It really contributes to the overall presentation of the thing. The visuals strike that balance of looking good while still taking just how much is going to happen on screen into consideration. The difficulty is at just the right level for both the taste of play and for those looking for a challenge in beating it. And a room full of bonus material doesn't hurt either. If you have any interest in tower defense games, give this one a stab. The possibilities within it are endless. Probably.